Yesterday, I'm contacted by somebody, and I've had this conversation so many times through the years. I can't count them all, but it did remind me of a book, and I think this book was published in 1997. And sadly, the author is somebody that I would have loved to have reached out and had a conversation with, but I never did. And he passed away in November of 2014. He was 74 years old. His name was Richard W. Halstein. And there's the book, Memoirs of a Recovering Autocrat. It's a great book. It's just a little thin book. I bought this book a long time ago because I found myself trying to not only help myself, but help other people who found themselves in the presence of an autocrat, or more specifically, working for an autocrat. An autocrat is a control freak. Now, I'm a control freak, and you may be a control freak, but there's a vast difference in being a little bit of a control freak and being an autocrat. Let me read some of what's on the back of this book, and if you may have to go to a used bookstore if you can find it online used, absolutely. Well worth the price. I'm going to encourage you to buy this book, read this book. It's a great book. Could you be an autocrat? Do you sometimes encourage competition instead of collaboration? Do you sometimes demand perfection from yourself and others, feeling you must either be a hero or a failure? Do you surround yourself with people just like you, thereby avoiding the conflict that comes with diversity? Do you use sink or swim tactics to continually test people? Do you hold on to the power you have instead of enjoying the privilege of sharing it? Here's help. In Memoirs of a Recovering Autocrat, you'll find a guide for managing in a world where the respect and protection formerly afforded authority are gone. Relief from the burden of feeling that you must be in control of everything all the time. It's a great little book and timeless. And it was written again in the late 90s. The application today is just insanely high. So here's what prompted this. So yesterday, a person reaches out to me, and this person works for someone who is an absolute autocrat, somebody who is a peer over the shoulder, somebody who is a complete control freak, somebody who gets onto employees if they see them conversing on the job. I mean, a real pain in the you-know-what kind of a person. A person that, quite frankly, every time I hear these kinds of stories, I just am so curious to find out, why did this person even get to this position? Why is this person in charge of people? People who have absolutely zero ability to relate to other people and understand the human dynamics in a workplace. I'm fascinated. I'm just fascinated by small and big business alike, small organizations and large organizations that will empower someone who just absolutely does not have the skill for leadership. And it just amazes me. So here's a person, a highly productive person, performing some very critical tasks, some very critical chores in this enterprise. And the boss, the autocrat, decides that there is this other task that she herself kind of does, but she really doesn't want to do that. And so instead of looking at the team and figuring out the best application for that, this person evidently, based on the information I was given, this person does what so many autocratic bosses do, takes a look at who are my stars, who's doing a really good job. Well, I'm going to give them this other job. And we all of a sudden, we take this highly productive, high-performing person, a rock star at the things that they're doing, and we take this happy, highly productive person and we turn them into a person who can't stand to be there. And that's exactly what happened. That was the conversation. So this person had gone from being very engaged, loving the work, doing a great job, with now one more thing put on her plate, four things now instead of three. And this fourth one, not the thing for which she was even hired and is now absolutely doesn't want to get up and go to work. And you're like, how does that flip? How does that switch get flipped so quickly? Because autocrats have that ability. Autocrats have the ability to make a person go from happiness to dread in a nanosecond because of their control freakishness. So what do you do? Well, you do the only thing that I think you can do. If you are subjected to an autocrat, I'm just going to tell you, get out. Just get out. Make haste and get away from the autocrat as quickly as you can. Number one, you are not going to convert an autocrat that doesn't want to be recovering. The recovering autocrat is going to be a person who wants to recover. They want to alter their behavior. They want to improve. They want to grow as a leader. In my experience, most autocrats do not want that. They are the center of the universe. The world revolves around them and their needs, and they don't much care about anybody else. And that's how it rolls. And so if you are tethered to an autocrat, I'm going to tell you, cut the tie. Just make haste and cut the tie as quickly as you can, because life is really about two things, energy and dread. And they're both different sides of the same coin. You've got to manage your energy. You want to do things that elevate your energy, because that's going to elevate your performance and obviously your happiness. But dread, man, dread will just suck you dry, and it's just terrible, terrible, terrible. Get out from under that very quickly. You want buy that book and give it to the autocrat, but you're not going to win friends, and you're not going to influence the autocrat. They are going to have to come to their own realization that they themselves are making their own life and the performance of their organization far worse than if they would behave differently. Yeah, but I'm not going to challenge you to be the person to give them that instruction. They are going to have to come to themselves, because they're the smartest people in every room that they enter. It's the nature of the autocrat. So read the book. Hold a good thought for the family of Richard Halstein, who wrote this book. He's been dead, it'll be 3 years this November. He was 74 years old. And before I hit the record button, I thought, I'd like to connect with this guy. I had no idea that he had passed. So I'll end on that note. Make today count. Don't stay tethered to an autocrat, because all of our days are numbered. Spend your days elevating your energy. Don't spend your days filled with dread. My name is Randy Cantrell. The website is growgreat.com. Thanks.